are three rungs of the ladder. If L will be equal to 0, we will have one rung there. And when L is equal to 2, so we will have 5 rungs of that ladder. Now, as I see that these are n integer steps, so it means that when M is running from minus L to plus L in n integer steps, then I can write that L is equal minus L plus N. So when N is equal to 0, I will have minus L. Then when N will be equal to 1, it will be minus L plus 1, and so on. And when we will reach the final value, then we will have N equal plus L. So they will, when means the N will be increasing. So here I know that it will be minus L plus this, this, and then we will have only the N value. So this implies that N, these integers comes out to be, this implies that L is equal to N over 2. 2L is equal to N and L equal N over 2. So this gives us another result that L and M can be integer as well as half integer as well. I will explain this in a while, that what is meant by that half integer. So it means that L means that L can be 0, 1, 1 half, 2, and 2, 0, 1 half, then 1 here, and further it will be then 3, 3 half, and then 3. Sorry, then 2 will come in, because 0, 1, 1 half, then we will have to write it in order. So it will be 0, half, 1, then 3 by 2, because 1 and 1 half will become 3 by 2. 2 and 2 half, so 2 half will become 5 by 2. And so on. While M will run as usual from minus L through 0 to plus L. So these half integer values I will have to explain a little bit in a while. So our eigenfunction F is the index N and the index L and M are there, so I will have to write it is F and M, and such that when L square operates on F Ln, the eigen function, it gives L into L plus 1 h bar square F Ln. And when Lz, one of the components, operates on this eigen function, it gives ML H bar F Ln. Now what are actually these FLMs? We don't know yet, because we have just taken it as eigen function. But what is this eigen function that we know? We got the eigen values, but so far we don't know the nature of this eigen function, which we will have to find out. So in section 4 4.3.2, we will discuss the eigenfunctions. And for that, we will have to go to the, because so far we have done all the calculations of L square in the Cartesian coordinates. So we will have to go to spherical polar coordinates, because we have solved the Schrödinger wave equation and spherical polar coordinates are theta and phi, and we will do it in three dimensions. So first of all, we will have to write the Lx, Ly, Lz in spherical polar coordinates. So first start with the L. We know that L is equal to R cross P, and R is here, P is R cross, P is minus IH bar del in three dimensions. So the value of del in spherical polar coordinates is equal to curly by curly R in R plus 1 over R curly by curly theta in theta unit vector, and 1 over R sine of the angle and curly by curly phi. So this is the value of del, and now we will have to write the del R cross del here. So this will imply that L is equal to R cross, so let me write this one, let me write this H bar over I, H bar over I and minus I H bar is the same thing, and then I will write R cross del. So R is here, that vector R is a magnitude R in a unit vector R, so it means that I will have to write R, for this is the magnitude, and then R unit vector, unit vector cross this R unit vector and curly by curly R. Then I will have to write, means first I will have to treat the unit vectors and then the magnitudes. So this will become R unit vector cross theta unit vector, as there is no R magnitude here, and curly by curly theta. Now let me look here. We are having R unit vector here, so R will come here, and this which is cancelled with this R, so we are having no R here, and then plus again here R will cancel, and we will have 1 over sine of the angle and curly by this R unit vector cross phi unit vector and curly by curly phi. So this is the R cross, this is R cross P, and which will give us the angular momentum. Now I know about these two, that R cross R, same vectors, and it will always give zero, the cross product. r cross theta and spherical polar coordinates, we know that when r is turned toward theta, then it gives phi unit vector. And when r is turns toward phi, when phi is turns toward r, it gives theta unit vector. But when r is turns toward phi, we will get minus theta unit vector. So when this is done, so we are having this term equal to zero, and we are left with L equals h bar over I, and this will be curly by curly theta in phi unit vector. This is curly by curly theta in phi unit vector, and then minus sign will come in, minus 1 over sine theta and curly by curly phi and theta unit vector. So we have successfully converted L into Cartesian, from the Cartesian into spherical polar coordinates. And now we will have to write that what are actually theta unit vector and phi unit vector. Now in spherical polar coordinates, we have calculated these, and one can review the classical electrodynamics lecture review of the Maxwell equations. We have calculated these theta and phi unit vectors. So theta unit vector is cos theta cos phi, cos theta cos phi, and I unit vector, and cos theta sine phi, cos theta sine phi, and j unit vector, and minus sine theta in k unit vector. While phi is a planar angle, so this has only two components, minus sine theta in I unit vector and plus cos phi in j unit vector. So we will have to put the value of theta unit vector here and phi unit vector here in order to get our L. So we will have now to put the theta and the phi values here. So this is L, and this is equal to h bar over I, h bar over I, curly by curly theta, and phi unit vector. So for phi unit vector, I will have to write minus sine theta in I plus cos theta in j. And minus sine theta in I, this shouldn't be theta, this should be phi, because this is the planar angle and this should be phi. Let me change this correct. So here this is phi and here this is phi. So we are having minus sine phi in I and cos phi in j, and plus we will have here minus. So minus h bar over I 1 over sine of theta, and then curly by curly phi, and we will have to write the unit vector now, theta unit vector, which is cos theta cos phi, and this is in I cos phi, this is in I unit vector, and cos theta sin phi plus cos theta sin phi in j unit vector, and minus sin theta in k, minus sin theta in k unit vector. So we will have to simplify this. So this is equal to h bar over I. Now the unit vector, it has nothing to do with this one because it can be written here or here, no problem with this. And curly by curly theta, here minus sine phi, and this is an I, so minus sine phi from there, and then here is also I, so h bar I is already there, and cos theta cos phi and I, but when this will come out of here, one more sine theta is there as well, so we will have to simplify minus sine phi curly by curly theta, and this is I unit vector, so another minus, and we are having cos phi, and then sin theta cos theta, sin by cos is cotangent, because sin by cos is tangent, so cos by sin is cotangent theta, and this one is in j unit vector, this one is in I unit vector, so I here, and then we are having one j here, so plus h bar over I, and cos phi, and here this one, so we are having cos phi, so let me write this one, cos phi curly by curly theta, cos phi, and then curly by curly